So how did the group start? So I can see where you were coming from and where you were going.
The challenges.
So one day you just started a Facebook group.
I'm just going to form. I need support and yeah. I can't get it from anybody.
Okay.
So I secretly started a group on Facebook.
Yeah.
I had no social media background. Didn't even have an Instagram account.
Mm.
I added 80 girls by hand, and the description is as is from that day, 24th of August, 2014. I said, girls, look, I'm struggling. We're all struggling. It's really hard. You know, we're banned from entering hotels, places, posh restaurants sometimes. You know, I need help. And as selfish as this sounds, I was helping myself.
Sure.
Woke up the next morning, 2,000 girls. Wow. And I was like, okay, wait, how did that, literally, overnight. Wow. 3 months later, 40,000. And it's a closed community. It's not a page. It's a group. So people are added by invite. And then, you know, we accept them. But at the time, we weren't looking at all the members. It just kept exponentially growing until we hit 40,000. And then TV stations started to contact me because it's trying to be like a small movement. Mm. You know, but who is this girl? Like, I'm a nobody. You know, like I'm a nobody who found this like movement.
Mm.
Speaking up, it's like a Me Too sort of thing. You know, like, yes, I was discriminated in Amsterdam airport or the Paris or the UK or the US. And I have my own personal experiences, as funny as it is, you know. And then I got the idea to write an email to Coach Tom Wolf,
sure.
And be like, you know, there is no Muslim woman representation in the sports space. Mm. I'm a triathlete. Sprint triathlons, but because his wife is an iron woman, you know. But like, I'm, you know, I do triathlons, I climb mountains, I'm a scuba diver, you know. But there is nobody that looks like me, and I'm writing to you as the number one, you know, global giant multinational sports brand in the world. And
because he was at Nike at the time,
he was managing the coaches, And I got his email from Sal, who was working as a Nike trainer at the time, and then he responded. And I was like, oh my God, you know, just the fact that he wrote back just gave me so much hope in that we can change the world by just having an open conversation. Met up with him. I became the first
ambassador.
Yeah. You know, so like women.
I love it.
You know,
there'll be a few of these in this conversation. Yeah. The mountains, marathons.
I don't know why people don't like it. I'm taking like, you know, credit for my achievement.
I love it.
So and then a few months later, a few years later, you know, like, of course, you know, my story with Nike is a dream that I'm currently living, of course. But back to surviving hijab, it's been, what, 6 years now? We're 930,000 women from all around the world.
Incredible.
2018, Mark Zuckerberg launched the Community Leadership Award.
Mm-hmm.
I applied. It was mainly trying to target the top 100 influential communities creating change in the world. I applied, I submitted everything. I won, like, you know, my community won. And before that, and Tom was on board, like preparing me with everything and giving me tips. 2018, I was invited to go speak at the, you know, you don't really like understand what's happening. Like when you get an email, would you be open to speak to our, you know, like the GMS? And I'm like, what is GMS? And they're like, the global marketing and sales.
Just for clarity for listeners, this is an email that's come directly from Facebook head office.
Yeah. You know, and I'm like, yeah, sure. And you know me, like, I'm just like winging everything. And I'm like, yeah, I would love to speak to your company, you know, like, when is it? And what's the number of audience like we're looking at and where? And then the email, you know, comes back. It's San Francisco. Whoa, 5,000 people.
Yeah.
And it's like, are you going to say yes or are you going to like back out?
Yeah.
It's 5,000 people. It was like the biggest audience I've ever stood before and spoke. And I honestly, like, I don't know how I did it. Like I watched that talk. I don't know how I did it. Like I was so chill, but they prepare you really well. Like I was on like phone calls with the States 2 weeks, you know, in advance, just like back and forth rehearsals. And you know, they fly you in a week before every day.
Nice.
You're just like going back and forth on stage with the lighting, with the mic. And you know, I was so emotional every time rehearsing, but then on the day I didn't cry. You know, which I think was okay because I was so grounded, and then I got a standing ovation.
Nice.
I went to Nike's.
It's incredible, absolutely incredible.
It was weird, you know. And then I found out that Sheryl Sandberg was going to be on stage right after me. So I was like begging them. I was like, 1 minute. I just want to see her for 1 minute, please. I read the book. lean in, I love you. You know, it changed my life. And then, you know, she overheard me and she was like, bring her. You know, so I went to see her, and of course she's got like a whole team.
It's sure. not, yeah, yeah.
Of course, then when I started crying because she's like my hero, you know. And she's so nice. And you know how they tell you, be careful when you meet your heroes because yeah, they yeah. might not be like what,
yep.
She was exactly what I expected, even more. You know, her warmth, her love, and she's just fantastic. And she gave me a hug, and then I went on stage. I think at that point I was ready.